Shoe review time. Again.
Let's review some shoes.
Also again, a Xero shoe.
In fact, it happens to be
this one. I'll have to find out the name of this because I don't know yet. To quote Xero shoes directly, this is the most minimal of their minimal shoes. So as you watch the video, keep that in mind. But I have something to disclose. Full truth time about these. If you know my Xero history, I was given a pair to review and I didn't review them. Then I reviewed a pair and I liked them. Then I did a follow-up review where I pointed out some things about them that I didn't like. And that leads me to this. I was handed this by the founder and owner of Xero Shoes as a gift after doing his podcast.
I could dance, but I'm not going to dance. That would require dancing, which that's not going to happen.
Are you scared of being a beginner?
No.
Whoa, there we go. There's your TikTok right there. I would like to state, though, that I will still bring full integrity and honesty to this review. What a strange relationship I've had with this company. I haven't been very great about reviewing their shoes. I dropped the ball on one and I had issues with one of the other shoes. And yet somehow, Steven, the founder, invited me to the podcast and then gave me more shoes. Whoa, welcome to the bluest shoes I've ever owned. You're gonna be able to see me from space. But other than that, I'm very excited about them. Or even because of that, I'm very excited about them. Let's do my little dance. But I felt it best to let you know that's the story behind these, and you will still get a completely honest review. Now, a quick timeline of my many minimal shoe reviews. In the beginning, I compared everything to the Feiyu.
When I do choose to finally put shoes on my feet, it's these, Feiyus.
I loved my Feiyu, 25 bucks on Amazon, and they were great. Then the bar was set much higher when I discovered the Tadivos. And since then, everything has been compared to the Tadivos, which are a grand, wonderful, strange, but beautiful minimal shoe. So these have a lot to live up to, and it would behoove you to see if they make the cut. A quick story about what I would view the perfect shoe as. Now, I've always believed as a patron of the barefoot arts that the moccasin would be the perfect shoe. Now keep in mind, I have no idea what an actual authentic old school beautiful moccasin would actually feel like. I'm not talking about the kitsch that you buy at the roadside store with the nice little cushion on the inside and all that. No. My idea, now I don't know if this is right or wrong. I could have spent 10 minutes on Google looking this up before this video, but I wanted to let you see behind the scenes of what goes on in my brain. Ever since I was a kid, I romanticized the moccasin as something very, very soft, like a buckskin or a calfskin, and foot conforming, and yet kind of tough at the same time. Could take a little bit of abuse. Probably very comfortable. Now this vision of the moccasin was, say, like straight off the plains of this continent before the word America was ever spoken. Is this reality? Is this really how a moccasin felt or was created or worked? I don't know. But in my mind, a moccasin was the perfect shoe. I've tried to find a shoe that felt like what I believed the moccasin felt like. I've tried a ton of minimal shoes. And not just minimal shoes, but like weird minimal shoes. Wrestling shoes, not moccasin-like, at least in my mind. I've tried ballet slippers more than once. Not even close to what I think a moccasin would be like. And the esteemed Tadivos, no, they felt like a bedroom slipper, like an aggressive bedroom slipper. That's not a bad thing. But they didn't feel like a moccasin. You know where this is going. This feels like what I think a moccasin should feel like. High praise in the comfort department. When I'm wearing these, they're nice. Like soft buckskin, which makes my vegetarian soul sort of skizz out a little bit. But then I realize that it's not. I don't think there's an animal product on this thing. I don't know what material this is, but boy, is it soft on the feet. I should show you this too. The way this shoe works, and the way I think several Xero shoes work, is not only are the laces tightening here, but the lace is also attached to this strap, or multiple straps that go around the shoe. So when you tighten the laces or loosen the laces, you're also tightening or loosening how the shoe conforms to your foot. So nice. I have wide troll feet, which is why so many minimal shoes don't work for me. I wanted to love the Merrells, and they just always felt a little cramped. I used to wear Chuck Taylors all the time until my feet were actually damaged from them. And so finding a minimal, comfortable shoe that's snug, not tight, but snug around my fat troll feet, I'm a little overwhelmed with how much I like these on the feet so far. Doesn't mean they necessarily perform well. Let's find out. I'm on the road. I'm camping every night. I'm going from Texas to California. It's taking me about 8 days, and I'm having a lot of fun in the process. And early on in the trip, I was given these, which now means all my play gets to be centered around how well these do. I'm pretty excited about that. So join me and Kolau as I travel and explore and test out these shoes, the name of which hopefully I've posted by now. I have no idea what they're actually called. But again, this will be an honest review because that's how I roll. If these end up sucking, I'll let you know. Sure, they feel comfortable. Will they hold up to what I want them to do, though? That's more important to me. A shoe has to be able to explore the world with me. A shoe has to make me feel confident that I can go try. Just go do weird stuff. Do these hold up? Let's find out. It's day one with the new Xero shoes. I still don't know what they're called. I'll have to look that one up, I guess. Anyway, we're gonna go for little walks all throughout the day. We got a long drive heading into Utah. Right now we're currently in Colorado. And so I just figure I'm gonna walk and climb and play and do the usual stuff I do with shoes and see how they do. I'm hoping they got the grip that I want and that they can handle what I'm gonna put them through. They're gonna go through the paces. Here we go. Da, 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 da. They're just flat and blue and very, very comfortable. Now normally for something like this, despite my minimal shoe-ness, it's cold and it's rough and I usually put on some boots, but not today. Gonna try out my new friends on my feet and see how they do. So normally I just feel a little more secure with something slightly more rugged would be the word on my feet, or I'd throw in some boots. I have not noticed a lack of confidence again in the Xeros. In fact, I've been on this trail for a while and I just now realized that I haven't thought about them. And as I've mentioned in many of my minimal shoe reviews, that's the sign of a wonderful minimal shoe. You actually don't think about them. You just do your stuff. You never have a concern about what's on your feet. And that's what's happening right now. So I'm gonna continue to explore. Here we go. So every week I film a bonus workout for my website, for the members of my website. It's a bonus workout because there's already multiple programs on there. And these are little workouts they can throw in between or add to the program. It's very malleable. It's a template that they can mess with, so they can always take new things and add it to there. So I like to film those in interesting locations, and out in the woods is always great. I also like to try to promote the fact that I don't use a lot of tools, or that you don't need a lot of tools. In this case, we're gonna use a rock. So I also get to test out the shoes while filming a fun little video for my folks. Get a couple of them going and then launch. See where my arms are? See how they're reached straight up? Snap and reach. I have a small problem though. My rock hit the ground, then rolled down the hill. So I might have to find a different angle to shoot this from. Okay, so you know I love climbing trees. One of my tests will be the tree test. Let's see how it goes. Oh, they work pretty well for that. Always the dog butt. So, yeah, I can play hard in these, and they let me. And they're not complaining in any way. I'm not even exactly sure where we are, but it's nowhere. Once again, I'm gonna be easily spotted. Dun, 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 dun. But then, so is she. Yeah, it's actually gently snowing on us right now. Thank you.
How do your weapons work?
So I'm filming even more for my YouTube channel here at Kyle Hot Springs, which is this strange little, it's hard to explain. You can go check out my Kyle Hot Springs workout video to learn more about it. So far we've been through a lot, and they're pretty amazing. They meet my requirements. They're nice and flat and minimal, they're grippy, and they just feel good. They're that confidence builder that I love in a good minimal shoe. They make you feel like you can. I'm a fan of exploring stuff, and these make me feel like I can, and that's important. I've mentioned before how I've wanted to love a shoe. There might be a little bit of that happening here. This is one of those situations though where I'd marry somebody for their personality, not their looks. Not sure about the blue, but I'm caring less and less the more I wear them because they're so fun to wear.